Jump Cannon was born in 1863. She was taught by her mother the names of constellations, which sparked her lifelong fixation with the sky. As she grew older, Annie got a place at Wellesley, studying physics and astronomy. The cold climate in the area led to frequent infections, and in one sad instance, Cannon was diagnosed with scarlet fever. As a result, she became almost completely deaf. Despite this, Cannon graduated with a degree in physics in 1884. Unfortunately, due to the limited scientific career opportunities available to women, she grew bored and restless. Her hearing loss made socialising difficult, which was not helped by her being one of the oldest in her area. She was able to gain better access to a telescope by enrolling at Radcliffe College, which was a college set up near Harvard where professors repeat their lectures. The Harvard Observatory director recruited Cannon in 1896. She was able to complete the Henry Draper catalogue, mapping and defining every star in the sky. Not long after Cannon was hired and work began, Antonio Maury, Henry Draper's niece, disagreed with Wilhelmina Fleming, as Maury insisted on a complex classification system as opposed to Fleming's straightforward approach. Cannon's knowledge allowed her to compromise by examining the bright southern hemisphere stars. She used a third system, a division of stars into the spectral groups OBA, FGKM. Sadly, her and all her female astronomers working at the observatory earned 25 cents per hour, which was definitely not reflective of her work. Her Draper catalogue listed nearly 230,000 stars, as well as publishing other catalogues of stars and other magazines, including 300 that she discovered herself. Her career lasted more than 40 years, during which time women were gaining some acceptance within the scientific community. In 1941, Cannon passed after being named the William C. Bond Astronomer at Harvard in 1938, as well as the first single female to win the Henry Draper Medal from the National Academy of Sciences in 1931. On top of this, she was the first woman to receive an honorary doctorate from the University of Oxford.